Hi, I'm Kathryn Colleen, and today we're going to be talking about what the 11 stages are and where they came from. The 11 stages are a cycle of mental states, ways of identifying ourselves to ourselves, definitions of ourselves that we cycle through over the course of our lives, and we go through them over and over and over and over and over. So where did they come from? They came from a long line of fantastic researchers, psychologists, thinkers, authors, and spiritual leaders, a number of which we're going to talk about here in this quick video, but there are many, many more. Primarily, Maslow. You may be familiar with Maslow's hierarchy of needs. This talks about how we go through life seeking to achieve different levels of needs. And once we have one level satisfied, we tend to go to the next. But he was just one person who had a piece of this cycle correct. Another one was Keegan. Keegan, along with Fowler, had done fantastic research. Keegan was working on social development, stages of social development that we all go through over time. Fowler was working on religious development, stages of religious development that we go through over time. So here now you have Maslow working on stages of need fulfillment that we go through. Keegan talking about how we develop socially in relationship to ourselves and other people. And Fowler talking about how our sense of religion or our spirituality develops over the course of our lives. Good stuff, but there was more to come. Fantastic thinkers like Sri Aurobindo and Jane Lovinger had further ideas about additional stages that happened. So when I took each of these researchers and I looked at the stages that they had developed, I found that they kind of overlapped, that they were all looking at different pieces of the same elephant. So I put them all together and I found this long stretch of 11 different stages that encompass everything from our social development, our religious development or spiritual development, our development in relationship to our needs, what we need, what we're seeking in this life. And it had it all in there, absolutely everything. And it was wonderful. But then the really, really important part is in the West, we often think of stages as a staircase. It's achievement. We're supposed to achieve and always go up and never go down. But that's not how it works. It's a cycle. It's a cyclical set of stages, and we go through them over and over and over and over. So what can seem like you're going backwards is really you're just going through the beginning stages again. And that's where the stages came from. They are a comprehensive way to understand where you are in your life, where your coworkers are in their lives, where your customers are in their lives, and therefore how you should address them, how you should work with them, how you can help them and be of real value, how to be a better manager and a better leader, how to be a better service provider, how to be a better team member. And that's why it matters. In some of the other videos that we're going to be posting, we'll be talking about what each stage is and how to recognize it, as well as what it means for things like marketing and employee retention and a few other areas that you might want to pay attention to. Thanks for joining me in this video. We'll see you in the next one.